Want to hear a fairy tale? Once upon a time, there was a sweet little princess born to a poor French-Canadian family, the youngest of 14 children. This little girl, let's call her Celine, loved to sing. By age 5, she was standing on tables in her family's humble restaurant, belting out tunes for the customers. She was not beautiful. In fact, kids poked fun at her pointy teeth and called her the vampire. But by age 12, this little princess had made a tape and sent it to a knight in shining armor, a Canadian record producer. Let's call him Rene. He was enchanted by Celine and mortgaged his castle to finance her first record. She was an instant hit and toured Europe, but still something was missing. She was too young, too green, spoke no English, and there was the issue of those teeth. She dropped out for a year and fixed everything, and the little Canadian goose emerged a beautiful, shining swan. The Princess of Pop became arguably the most successful recording artist of the decade. And her name, Celine Dion, became synonymous with dramatic movie theme songs. The theme from Titanic has sold nearly 60 million copies.
Thank you so very much. Have a wonderful evening.
And won Celine another Grammy for Record of the Year. And the success continued with another hit, The Prayer. The duet partnered Celine with Italian tenor Andrea Bocelli. Up soon for Celine is an album of her greatest hits that will also include some new material. Her talent is big, and so is her approach to each song. In Celine's world, more is more, which makes her easy to mock on shows like Saturday Night Live.
And welcome to my show. I am Celine Dion, and I am the best singer in the world.
And this fairy tale has a happy ending, or middle. In 1994, there was a royal wedding between the knight who discovered her and the little girl with the big voice. It was no small affair, and the 26 years between them seemed to magically evaporate on their wedding day. Rene Angelil and Celine Dion are partners now in every sense of the word.
I got class, so you go first.
They spend most of their time between homes in Montreal and here in Florida. The couple's latest obsession, golf. Sadly, though, a few weeks after our interview, Rene was diagnosed with cancer. He was treated and is expected to make a full recovery. But he was in great form when last we talked.
Rene, what did you see in Celine when she came to you as a 12-year-old child that made you think she could be a star?
Well, you have to understand that at that time I was 39 years old. I had been in this business for 20 years, and things weren't so great for me. So she came in the office with her mother, and she was singing. Her voice was like a voice of an angel. Really, I had chills. She got me.
Celine, when is the last concert going to be?
Last concert, New Year's Eve.
But after 18 years in the business and at the peak of her success, it may be coming to an end. Talking with Celine in her Florida home, we learned that she wants something more.
Everything that's been happening to us, it's so overwhelming. It's so much. It's the reason why we want to stop now. It's the success and the money and everything is like much too much, and it's time for us to stop now and have a normal life.
But you know, usually when one is terribly successful, that's when you want to go on. You know, you don't usually say when you're barely 31 years old, I'm going to stop. I mean, that's amazing.
I don't want to wait 10 years. I don't want to wait 5 years. I prefer to take my gold medal and retire now. And I don't want people to be tired of hearing me or seeing me. It's much too much.
How long are you thinking of stopping for?
2 years at least.
At least?
At least 2 years.
No records, no touring, no nothing?
No, no. We would love to work on a little family. And the thing is, Barbara, is
wait,
the
wait,
fact...
Wait.
We would like to work in a little family. Isn't that what it's all about?
For sure. That's the most important thing for us. We would love to take some time for both of us, work on a little family. We won't have 14 children. No way.
Do you think that because you have been working, you have not been able to be pregnant?
Yes.
Do the doctors feel that yes. What you need is some rest?
Yes, definitely. There's nothing wrong with my health. A lot of things been said about it.
Yes.
But I'm telling you, there's nothing wrong about my health. I love what I do, but now it's time for me to take a break. If I need, this baby needs time. It needs, it probably doesn't work now because the baby's probably saying, well, you don't have time for me yet. So if you have time for me, maybe I'll come and join you.
Just for the record, you're not pregnant now?
I'm not.
You know the rumors that you're anorexic?
Yes, I know about it.
Do you watch what you eat?
No, I do not.
So this is just that you're naturally thin, or why are you so thin?
I'm naturally thin. I eat whatever I want, and I don't have any weight problem yet.
I hear you have 500 to 1,000 pair of shoes. What's with you and the shoes?
I do. I'm a shoe freak. I really love shoes. I have close to 1,000 pairs, I think. I don't know, I just love shoes, and I prefer love shoes than some people, they're on drugs, some people, they eat too much, some people, they don't eat enough, we all have a little something.
And
me,
shoes?
It's shoes.
Okay. I understand that before a performance, for example, the day before, you don't talk, and
right.
That you won't sneeze out loud or cough out loud, all of this regimen that you do for your voice, true? Mm-hmm.
I don't talk at all, I don't whisper. I cough differently. I don't cough like, I cough like this. I can't laugh. I go like, I laugh differently. Laughing is probably one of the worst things to do the night before a concert because it irritates, you get tired. Renee loves those days when I don't talk.
I'll bet
because
I'm
a big talker. But I don't talk and I'm a very disciplined person.
So now you can talk and laugh.
Now I can talk and I can have dairy products. I can have everything I want.
Take me back to those early years, the youngest child in a family of 14.
That's right.
Now you live in a marble palace. Then you slept, what, four in a room?
We used to sleep like 3-4 people in the same bed. Mm-hmm. Yes. But it was wonderful times. It was, money-wise, it was hard. We never know what was going to eat. But with my mother, we were not afraid. She always found solutions. She's wonderful. She's my idol. I look up to her. My dad was the hard worker one. My mom raised us with nothing. And when you talk to her, they haven't been to school. They didn't know how to write. I was ashamed of that. My parents cannot write. They make mistakes when they write. Well, today it's my turn. I make mistakes, but I love them.
And these days you can take care of them. That must be a great joy.
Yeah.
You were singing when you were 5 years old and on the table in the little sort of tavern that your parents ran.
A piano bar, that's right. And my mom didn't really like it. It was not a healthy place for me. And not the way that she wanted me to do a career, a real career, a professional career with your own songs. So I looked at her and I agreed, but what do we do? My mom wrote me my first song, but today I cannot believe it. Without knowing how to write, but just with the sound and feeling, she wrote a song to me. It was only a dream. That was the title of the song. Ce n'était qu'un rêve, a French song, of course. And one of my brother and me sat on the floor with a guitar and a tape cassette. We composed the music, and it started my whole career. So my mom started my dream.
This tape was sent to a man who was a big deal in the record industry in Canada.
That's
named
right. Rene Angelil.
Rene Angelil. The husband today.
That's right.
The manager all your life.
That's right.
So he gets this tape sent by the family of a 12-year-old kid. What happens?
He asked me to sing in front of him just to make sure I could sing and I could manage. And he started to cry. And I looked at my mom and I was very proud of it because I think I've done the job.
I know you have a cold, but that first song that you sang that your mother wrote, can you just do a bar or two of us?
Of course, I'll try with this bit. You'll go. Ce n'était qu'un rêve, ce n'était qu'un rêve, impossible à oublier dès que le jour se lève.
This is with a cold. With a cold and without violins. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Pleasure.
As a teenager, singing in Montreal, you only sang in French. Mm-hmm. And then you learned English very quickly.
I remember I went on stage. I was 14 and I couldn't speak English and I was singing, "What a feeling." Everybody were dancing with me, clapping hands. "You go, girl, Celine." And I didn't understand a word of what I was singing at that time. Nothing. I couldn't understand anything. So I went to school and I learned English, and since then I'm still practicing, I'm still learning, and I still make mistakes, but it's getting better with time.
But your English now is fluent.
Not too bad. I can communicate.
You did this interview, so you're doing okay.
Phew.
All this time, Renee saw you as this not terribly attractive, awkward little girl with a great voice. But let's talk about the romance. Mm-hmm. When did it happen? When did things change?
It changed. We were in Dublin. In 1988, and it was a different kiss goodnight.
You were 20?
I was 20 years old. Mm-hmm. That's right. I started to, after this kiss goodnight in Dublin, on the lips for the first time, my whole body started to shake. And then I said to myself, well, maybe that's love. Maybe that's the thing.
Renee is 26 years older than you.
That's right.
Did it bother you then? Does it bother you now?
Never did, never will. Renee is the most fantastic, who loves me. Nobody will ever love me as much as this. It was hard for my mom. It's been hard because my mom always wanted to protect me. He's been married 2 times before. He's got 3 children. Come on, Celine. I want the Prince of Charm for you. Yeah. And now I come with a man 26 years older than me. It's not the perfect scenario, but what is perfect?
Is it the same way today with you and Renee?
It's even better.
Really?
Because I get to know him better, and I cannot wait to get to know the husband better. And that's another one of the reasons why I want to stop.
Let us hope that he lives to be 125.
But thank you.
There may come a time when you are on your own and you've had all this protection.
Yes.
Will you be okay?
I'll be fine. I'm a very strong person. He gives me so much. I learn and I take the best out of him. It's a wonderful heritage.
Are you at all concerned, or is Renee concerned, of what happens for the 2 years that you don't sing at all? What happens to the career?
We're not concerned about that at all. Because, let's put it that way. Let's say that in 2-3 years from now I come back. Mm-hmm. Because I'll miss singing for sure. Mm-hmm. But let's say I come back because I think we have wonderful new songs and it doesn't work for me.
Yeah.
It's over. I'm not holding on. When I was little, I was holding on to a song and I was holding on to my career. I had one dream and it was to become an international singer, travel the world, sing, 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 and sing. Mm-hmm. Music is wonderful. It's a way to express yourself, but it's not all.
Is this now the best time of your life?
It is. I think for every woman in your 30s, it's got to be the best. You are young enough to start things, and you are just old enough to not be stupid. So you're just smart, starting to wake up. So in the 30s, it's wonderful, but it's got to be the best time of my life now. And maybe that's why I want to stop.